Good morning, my name is Shaltiel Schmidman, and I'm going to be discussing several tasks for pre-processing historical Hebrew text using DeepLearning. This is joint work with Avi Schmidman, Moshe Kopel, and Yael Goldberg. This research was done at DITRA, the Israel Center for Text Analysis, directed by President Moshe Kopel. Most of the work done on Hebrew NLP has been done on modern Hebrew, whereas our work focuses on rabbinic Hebrew from the medieval and early modern times. For example, commentaries on the Talmud from the 11th and 12th century, and commentaries on the Torah and the Shulchan Aruch from the 16th, 17th, and 18th century. We were met with three key challenges when processing these texts. The first key challenge is that the existing digital corpora suffer from many errors, both typographical and OCR-related. The second key challenge is that the texts were not vocalized, that is, they did not have nikud. The third key challenge is that the text contained many abbreviations, many of them ambiguous. Here is a sample paragraph from the Beit Yosef. The Beit Yosef is a 16th century halachic work. As you can see, the text is not vocalized. Also, in the second line, there is an error where a chet has switched with a tav. Also, in just this small paragraph of text, there are four different abbreviations. The key to overcoming these challenges is to take the surrounding context into account. Our primary tool for taking the surrounding context into account is the bidirectional recurrent neural networks, or specifically, the LSTM. The LSTM is based on a gated architecture and has been shown in recent studies to achieve great results when processing sequences of textual data of arbitrary length. Our first project is error detection. Our objective is to take a long text which contains errors and automatically flag all the suspected errors. These texts have been proofread by many humans, but they have not managed to eradicate all the errors. Therefore, every mistake that we find is a very valuable contribution. This topic has received some attention in recent research, for instance, Al-Azawi's thesis of 2015. However, no research has been done on this topic regarding rabbinic Hebrew. This task is especially hard with rabbinic Hebrew, since in the medieval and early modern times, there was no standardized spelling, and any given word can be found in the malet form with chavzidiyos or the chaser form without chavzidiyos. Therefore, the spell checker method is not very effective. We found multiple types of errors that occur in these tests. For example, letters that are missing, added, or transposed, or OCR mistakes, where similar-looking letters get switched. For example, chet and tav, or kaf and bet. Also, keyboard mistakes, where two letters that are near each other on the keyboard get switched. For example, aleph and lish. Here are a few real examples from a live rabbinic corpus online from sefaria.org. In the first case, the word should actually say bitshuvah, but the hey is missing. In the second case, it should actually be chalva, but the chet and tav got switched, a classic OCR mistake. In the third case, it should actually be kolim, with an aleph, but the aleph and ayin got switched, possibly because they are near each other on the keyboard. We train a neural classifier to determine at each word position whether the given word is a mistake or not. For each given word, we consider three views of the word. The first view is an LSTM encoding of the characters of the given word. The second view is a bi-LSTM encoding of all the characters in the sections. The third view is a bi-LSTM encoding of all the words or vector embeddings of all the words in the sentence. We concatenate all three views together and feed them into an NLP for prediction of whether the given word is a mistake or not. During training, we automatically introduce errors, and we train the network to flag these automatically generated errors. With every iteration, we generate a new set of errors so the network doesn't overfit the specific word. Our corpus that we are trying to detect errors in is also the corpus that we use as a training corpus. We assume that the text is mostly correct, and the LSTM lens had it generalized so the actual mistakes don't impact the training. We ran our algorithm on the Beit Yosef text as digitized by Sefaria. We took the first 10% of the corpus and used it as a tessa. We found that the tessa contained 397 errors. Our goal is to train a network to find as many of these errors as possible. We trained a different neural network for each of the three error types. We combined all three methods together at a threshold of 50, and we achieved a recall of over 50%. We compared our method to three baseline methods. The first baseline method is unique unigrams, where we flag a word as a suspected error if the given unigram does not appear anywhere else in our corpus. Similarly with bigrams and trigrams. The bigrams and trigrams method achieved a recall of over a very high recall, but their precision was below 1%. In our test set, the trigrams method flagged over 243,000 words as suspected errors. The unigrams method did much better and only flagged 4,300 words as suspected errors. Our method, on the other hand, only flagged 1,250 words as suspected errors and still achieved a recall of over 50% better than the unigrams. To summarize, our method does not require any manual tagging, so we have plenty of raw tags available for training. Our method also manages to detect multiple types of errors and achieves a decent recall with a manageable precision. This project here makes automatic corpus construction feasible. Our second project is automatic vocalization. Our objective is to take a rabbinic text and automatically add vocalization to it. In contrast to modern-day newspapers, rabbinic texts are very hard to read without vocalization. Many words are ambiguous. Also, as we mentioned earlier, in the medieval and early modern times, there was no standardized spelling. So these two problems makes text processing more difficult and text searching less precise. We trained a neural classifier to determine at each letter position what the correct vocalization mark is on the given letter. We predict the vocalization mark for each letter based on three information sources. The first item is a BioLSTM encoding of just the characters of the correct word. The second item is an LSTM encoding of all the characters before and after the correct word in the sentence. The third item is an LSTM encoding of all the previously predicted vocalization marks in the sentence. We concatenate all three items together and feed them into an NLP for prediction of what the correct vocalization mark is. Although we train for each letter separately, we globally normalize the scores across each word in order to avoid the label bias problem. We use Bing search in order to find the optimal set of predictions on every given word. During training, when the correct option falls out of the beam, we perform an early update. Whenever we encounter a shin or a sin, we train a separate classifier to determine whether it is a shin or a sin. Our training corpus consists of the Bible, the Mishnah, and various vocalized rabbinic texts from the 11th to 13th century. Our test set is the Beit Yosef from the 16th century. Although the genres are overall similar between the test set and the training corpus, the writing styles are very different. We compared our method to Morphix's Nadine. Morphix's Nadine is the leading commercial vocalization utility based on an algorithm written by Professor Jakob Schlepp. We checked both word precision and letter precision, and in both cases, our method achieved a higher score than Morphix's Nadine by a large margin. In letter precision, we have an over 10% gain, and with word precision, even more so, an over 15% gain. We tested out our auto vocalizer in a sample paragraph of the Beit Yosef. Here you can see the paragraph vocalized. The LSTM even managed to get the Chatat Chatat in the words La'achila and La'chazol, and the Degishim in the words Mitzolchei and Sheyotzi. The LSTM is imperfect though, and it still missed a few words, for example, the word Hulevalek. We also found that Morphix's Nadine would often leave words blank without vocalization. The reason is because these words are in Aramaic and are not in Morphix's predetermined vocabulary. The LSTM, on the other hand, manages to generalize from words it has seen and predicts a reasonable set of vocalization marks for words it has not seen. We also tested out our auto-vocalizer on a more modern piece, a paragraph from the writings of Shayago, and here you can see it vocalized. To summarize, our method managed to learn an integration of both Aramaic and Hebrew in a single model. Our method is also not limited to a predetermined vocabulary. Our method is also not Hebrew-specific and can be generalized to other languages, for example, to Arabic. We hope to leverage vocalization to aid in automatic morphological analysis. Our third project is abbreviation extension. Here you can see a few examples of frequent ambiguous abbreviations in rabbinic texts. Our objective is to disambiguate and extend these abbreviations. Rabbinic texts contain a plethora of abbreviations, many of them ambiguous. This poses a difficulty for both text processing and text searching. Here's a sample paragraph from the Beit Yosef. This is the same paragraph shown at the beginning of the presentation. In just this small paragraph of text, there are four different abbreviations. Two of them are ambiguous. Ayin Kaf Lamed can be Ad Kan Lashono or Al Kofen Ulama. And Hey Mem can be Haneh Mile, Hefsed Meube, or Hadrat Melech. Looking at the surrounding context, it is easy to determine that Ayin Kaf Lamed should be Ad Kan Lashono and Hey Mem should be Haneh Mile, but in principle, each of the abbreviations can be looked at as any one of the expansions. We trained a separate network for each abbreviation. The training corpus for each abbreviation consists of sentences containing the naturally occurring expanded phrases, instances of the expansions for the abbreviation. Here you can see a few sample sentences from the training corpus for the abbreviation Ayin Hey. Ayin Hey can be Alav HaShalom, Am HaAretz, or a few other options. We train the neural classifier to determine for each abbreviation what the correct expansion is. We have two methods of input to the NLP. The first method is a concatenation of the three of the words of embeddings of the three words before and after the abbreviation. The second method consists of a concatenation of the following two items. The first item is an LSTM encoding of all the characters in the sentence before and after the abbreviation. The second item is a LSTM encoding of all the words of embeddings of all the words in the sentence before and after the abbreviation. We tested out both methods, and sometimes method one would provide better results. Sometimes method two would provide better results. We concatenated the input from both methods together and performed exceptionally well across the board. The best previous work on this topic reports 98% using supervised learning on specific books. Our method, on the other hand, does not require any manually tagged data, and the resulting classifier works for all rabbinic texts and not just specific books. Putting all three projects together, we wanted to demo our work here on a sample paragraph from the Beit Yosef. This is the same paragraph shown at the beginning of the presentation. As you can see, there is an error, multiple abbreviations, and the text is not vocalized. After running it through all three of our projects, here you can see the error fixed, abbreviations expanded, and it's auto-vocalized. To conclude, our work here provides solutions to the three problems we mentioned: error detection, vocalization, and abbreviation extension. Our work here allows us to create corpora amenable for both search and processing. All three solutions use LSTMs for exploiting context and are not Hebrew-specific and can be generalized to other languages. For two of our projects, for error detection and abbreviation extension, we do not require any manually tagged data, so therefore, we have plenty of raw text available for training. Thank you very much. I'll be happy to answer any questions. Across the entire rabbinic corpus that contained the expanded version of the abbreviation, we contracted it as if it was abbreviated, and Yeah, and that way we had automatically tagged things.
But how did you know that this is an abbreviation?
So we already had a list of all the abbreviations and their exceptions.
So when I was talking about this, I guess the thing that was hardest for me was the actual filtration, like where to stop, where to pause. Do you have any projects on that?
We do not have any projects yet on punctuation, but we hope to develop them in the future.
In your error detection model, you trained on the text with the errors in it, so there was noise in it. Did you consider training on a smaller corpus where you filtered the errors out first?
Well, we have no way of knowing what the actual errors are.
But I mean, you could go through a smaller corpus, filtering out the errors by hand,
and train
on that and see if you can compare the results you get to the larger training corpus with the errors included as noise.
Right. So that would require a lot more manual tag work. That's a good idea. We hope to try it in the future.
And one second question. You were using word models all the time?
Yes, words of academic.
Did you think of using character models on any of these tasks?
So with all three projects, wherever we use a word to back embedding, we also use an encoding of all the characters.
I'm talking about language models that are character models.
No, we did not think of that. But thank you for the idea. We will use it in the future.
Great work, first of all. I'd like to ask you about the word to back embedding in the Hebrew text and the Aramaic text. In English and Hebrew, there are lots of words that characters in the beginning, like the other solutions
for them.
How do you use that proper word to back embedding?
I've been in here again.
How did you separate that actual word from the other solution?
I mean, from prefixes? So we didn't separate it from prefixes. Use the words as it is.
In the words of
everyone.